Welcome to Second Take, the show that takes a look at the issues behind the news. The South African government this week initiated a far-reaching scientific study of shale gas development in the country. Terence Creamer joins me to discuss the implications. Hi, Terence.
Hi, Tracy.
So what has government launched exactly and why?
Well, you know, there's been a lot of opposition to moving ahead with shale gas mining and using the hydraulic fracturing or fracking method in South Africa before we know what the implications are scientifically around a range of issues. I think the highest profile issue has always been the water issue, given that the Karoo, which is where these resources are said to be, up to 380 trillion cubic feet plus of shale gas resources. There's a water scarcity issue, and fracking by its very nature is water intensive. But there are a number of other issues that the scientific community and opponents to fracking have felt that South Africa needed to interrogate. You know, there's this whole issue around the square kilometre array that's going to be going up in that Karoo area. And there was a view that maybe, you know, if you're going to have mining activities of this nature, it could impact the scientific data or the credibility of the SKA. So there's also that element. So what's really been launched by government, and it's a multi-departmental effort, is a strategic environmental assessment. So this is a high-level view of all the potential impacts of shale gas development in the Karoo. And this is going to take a 24-month, two-year period to develop. And it's going to involve about 12.5 million rand of investment. And there's going to be a lot of scientific resource. There's going to be an assessment of the international literature, but then a localization of that information to South African conditions. And we're going to have a lot of authors. It's a multi-author report, something like 50 authors covering different topics. And there's then going to be reviews of that work before it is published. So it's a major scientific endeavor, and one that I think the anti-fracking groups have welcomed. But it's also government trying to indicate that they want to be responsible in the way we approach this new industry.
And what are the implications for exploration, which has been put on hold for a number of years?
Well, that's, I think, the big question. The Department of Mineral Resources, which is part of the SEA development, said that there's going to be parallel exploration. So we're not going to be exploiting the resource or mining the resource, but there will be, they say, parallel exploration while this two-year study takes place. The rules of the game of that still have to be outlined to those licensees that want to go ahead with exploration. And the Department of Mineral Resources indicated that in June there should be some visibility of those rules. And that's going to really determine whether there's going to be appetite, I think, to continue with exploration parallel to this process, because there's no doubt that the strategic economic assessment is going to impact ultimately the way shale gas is mined in South Africa. The rules of engagement are going to be influenced by this process, and that does raise a risk factor for anyone entering into an exploration phase, because it could change the cost structures of exploitation. So I think it's going to be interesting to see what DMR's rules are, whether the risk associated with the SEA is such that it can be mitigated by the explorers, or whether that's going to mean that they'll hold back for a further 2 years.
And when do you think South Africa is going to resolve how it plans to develop the sensitive industry?
Well, I think this is an important step, and probably one that should have been taken some time ago. I mean, I think it is being led in a very serious way. It's being led by South Africa's top scientist in the form of Professor Bob Scholes. He's an internationally rated scientist. And the way they've structured this study is also very impressive from at face value. So there's going to be an emphasis both on content as well as process. And on the process issue, I think there's a process custodian group that's going to involve groups that are anti-fracking, as well as the industry, as well as government, to oversee that this process. And I think the three elements and the three building blocks that Professor Scholes outlined was salience, and it must be legitimate and it must be credible. So salience in the sense that it must cover all the issues that are worrying people about fracking. It must be credible in that the process must be inclusive, and it must be legitimate in the sense that the way that's written, it really is expert opinion, and it really is, you know, scientific led rather than opinion heavy. So I think that this it is a serious attempt to get to grips with this new industry, and I think that it's probably a step that should have been taken maybe before we were entered into the exploration phase. But the view is that we can do both. Whether the industry agrees when the DMR publishes its regulations is going to be interesting to see, because we have really had these three companies that have got licenses in a holding pattern since 2011. They would like to move ahead, but also the economic environment around shale gas and the energy environment has changed substantially given the fall in oil prices and gas prices. So that could also have an impact on their appetite. So I think what we're going to have is, in 2 years, proper visibility of how we're going to approach the development of shale gas mining. Whether there's parallel exploration is going to be interesting to see.
Great. Thanks, Terence. That is the Second Take Show for this week. Thank you for watching, and join us again next time for more news analysis.